Previously on Dream Team.
Was Ryan Naismith driving the car when you hit Mr. Wilson?
Yes.
You got to tell the police the truth.
I can't.
You don't understand!
You think I did?
I think you should plead guilty.
We've decided to offer you 3 years.
This is not what I want.
It's a red card for Fletcher. It's a red card for Naismith. They're down to 9 men.
That was the most pathetic display I have ever seen.
Robbie, you're not doing it. Clyde, you're off.
Just seconds left now. It's Sabatier! It's the winning goal! Harter's throw through to round four.
You were late for the game. Unacceptable. You lost it like some first-time youth player. Not the seasoned professional that you are. Totally unacceptable, Fletcher.
Walsh!
Consistently inconsistent, Walsh. One day great, the next bloody dreadful. Now shape up, concentrate and give me 110%. Or you're out of here.
Naismith!
Nightmare. Total nightmare. We back you over Tara, give you your big chance. And this is how you repay me. Get out.
I'd like to thank you for getting our day off cancelled.
Yeah, getting called in for extra training after we've won. Nice one, lads.
Oi. You didn't come home.
So
I was worried. Where were you?
I'm just off to work, I'm afraid.
Oh, right. Well, I won't keep you. It's just, well, me and Robbie are going out tonight and it's a bit of a special one.
Things going well, then?
Brilliant, Abby. It's been awful with Jamie being around. But things are sorting themselves out. And that's the reason for dinner tonight. I want to sort of do it formally.
Do what?
Ask him to move in with me. Tell him about the divorce.
You don't think it's a bit early?
I know it's the right thing to do, Abby. You think so, don't you?
That's a big one, Tash.
Well, look, don't tell anyone. I'm going to go and see a solicitor tomorrow.
All right, well, as long as you're sure.
It's the best thing for me and Hope and for Robbie.
All right, well, look, I'd love to talk more, but I've really got to go.
All right. Well, what I came round for is to see if you can look after Madam for me tonight while I go out.
Oh, I'm sorry. I promised Fletcher I'd make up for his missed day off.
Oh, OK. Well, I just thought I'd ask.
Good morning.
Is it? I've had enough.
Sorry?
Well, I'm locked away in here editing while Nikki's out there presenting.
But you know why. Until this Ryan situation is resolved, we have to keep you away from the players.
And I know why you might do something to help me.
What do you mean?
Unless you let me return to presenting, then Phil will be hearing all about...
Just leave it, Tara.
You think I wouldn't?
Jackie, have you got a moment?
I'm serious. I want all my job.
HUTV just isn't doing the business. Just had the figures back from Christmas and there's hardly any take-up. Just 5,000 subscribers. We need to at least double this if we're going to break even. Look, I know how much this means to you, but we need to take action. With the club's finances being the way they are, the club cannot be left to pick up this channel's shortfalls.
You mean close the station?
No. Other clubs have successful channels, so it must work. The problem might be with Tara.
Are you suggesting that we sack her?
Maybe.
You know, I don't think that's a good idea.
Well, we have to do something. I've made up my mind.
What we're looking at here is a conference side scoring goals for fun against a Premiership team. We should have beaten them easily. But we were unfocused and ill-disciplined.
which is why we're here today on our day off. Two players are responsible.
I didn't punch him. I was trying to break up. You can see that on the video.
You raised your hand. That's sufficient.
Well, we can use the video to appeal to the FA.
I only appeal when I know I can win. You're both fined 2 weeks' wages. Right, everyone, on the pitch now.
We've got a problem.
What?
Tara's threatening to tell Phil about us unless she gets her presenting job back.
You're wrong.
What do you mean?
We haven't got a problem. You have. Sort it out. I've got work to do.
But I haven't seen you for ages.
I'm busy.
I want to see you. Don't you want to see me?
I said I'm busy.
When are you not going to be busy?
See, my husband's in a good mood then.
Right. Today, we're going to work on defence. Now, there's no point in you two training with the first team, so I want you to do laps of the pitch for half an hour. Every time I blow the whistle, I want you to drop down and give me 10 press ups. Right. Come on then. Yeah, yeah.
It's just the way I'm feeling. Now, wait, who are we going to get to look after you tonight, eh? See who that is, yeah?
Sweetheart.
Dad, just the man I need.
You ready?
For what?
To go and meet Clive Connolly with me. You've forgotten.
It's today.
Don't let me down, love. He's potentially an excellent new client.
Okay. On the condition you babysit me. I promise Robbie a night out.
Natasha, it's transfer window time. What about Jamie?
I don't want to ask him.
You and Jamie are a nightmare all round. It's cost me dear for one thing.
Oh, so you see your daughter's breakup in terms of your bank balance?
Listen to me. Losing Jamie and Robbie as clients is no small thing. That's why we need to snap up Clyde. Also, I'm seriously concerned that my granddaughter doesn't have a father.
Robbie looks after Hope a lot better than Jamie ever could.
So you, Robbie and Hope can have a quiet evening in. Shall we go?
Get your mind on training.
I don't see why we're training when we've won.
Robbie, go and join Fletch and Ryan now.
Eh?
Just do it now.
What are you giving the gaffer lip for?
What's that supposed to mean?
Well, you know what sort of mood he's in, Muppet.
So what do with you, Fletch?
Press ups on my whistle. That's an extra half hour round the pitch for all of you.
Oh, come on, I'm doing them.
All of you.
Nice one.
We need to double the viewing figures for the next quarter.
Or else I'll lose my job.
We need to improve the quality of what we're doing and get the message out to the fans, or yes, I'm afraid I'll have to let you go.
I see.
I've just had an idea. Why don't we do a big feature on Phil?
You are?
What do the fans know about you? Very little. Let's do a big piece on him, about your passion for the club. About the lottery win. You know, behind the scenes.
I don't know.
We want to appeal to the fans. And you are the ultimate fan. And Tara, you can present the feature.
Yes.
But it has to be ready for transmission tomorrow.
All right, that'll do for today. Are you forgetting something?
You're just blowing for the end of training.
Not for you three. It's another half hour going around the pitch.
That's out of order, boss.
You want some more? That's another half hour going round the pitch. I'll have my lunch and I'll come back and check on you.
I'll tell you, the gaffer is bang out of order. He's having a bubble. Well, that's it. I'm not having this.
you coming?
Don't you think we should go back?
Well, go on then! You go! I'm not getting treated like that. He's got no right. Today's a day off and I'm going to enjoy myself.
We'll be in massive trouble tomorrow though, mate.
I don't give a monkey's. Right, boys. We're putting a grand in, right? The one with the least winnings gets the drinks in.
I am up for that.
Yeah, definitely, mate. Oh, hang on. I left my wallet at the club.
Oh, that old chestnut, eh? Don't worry, I'll stop you. Oh, no, turn your phones off. It's the three of us against the world.
Yeah.
Come on.
Do you know where Fletcher's gone?
I didn't know he'd gone.
If he calls, you tell him to get his arse into my office.
Is Fletcher on a runner?
Yep.
He'd be moping around at home or whinging to Jamie, I expect.
Yes! Come on, you beauty! Come on, Tommy, lad! Come on, you beauty! No. Yes! Yeah! 15 large ones up in the first race. The Fletcher's back! Come on! Champagne's on me, boys. Someone like it?
Natasha, she deals with the sponsorship and promotions. Don't you, Natasha?
Yeah. Yeah, excuse me a minute, Dad.
So, yeah, she deals with that.
Sandra, you couldn't do me a favour. I need a babysitter for tonight. I suppose you'd like to do the honours.
Oh, I'd love to, but I can't tonight. I'm booked up. Any other night, just give us a shout.
You can't walk off mid-interview.
Sorry.
Get back there and turn on the charm. I can't afford to lose him.
Sorry about that, Clyde.
Oh, it's no problem. I mean, this is it's all happening so fast for me that my head's spinning.
Yeah. What are you doing tonight?
I'm up for it. What do you fancy doing?
I mean, are you free to babysit for me?
You what?
I'll never forget the first time I went to Addison Road. It was my 8th birthday and my dad was taking me along as a surprise, but you know, I could tell by the look in his eyes where we were going from the moment, and I was quite excited. I'll never forget coming up the steps at the back and seeing the green of the pitch. It took my breath away. But all the players were my heroes. To run out with them, that was my dream. Of course, I was never good enough, but I suppose I just got older and I carried on dreaming. And that's the thing that kept me going at work, through all those hours, knowing that pretty soon I'll be part of that again. See the lads running out onto the pitch. My team.
It's fantastic.
That was really good, Phil. I think that we should expand the feature, make it a day in the life kind of thing, with Phil at work, at home, everywhere.
Sounds good.
Yeah, I'm up for that.
Right, wait here, I want me a minute.
Yeah, you're gonna be all right. She can be very difficult.
Yeah, I'll be fine.
I'm gonna have to get someone from an agency for you, darling. I didn't want to, but...
What?
Can I see my daughter?
No.
Don't be stupid.
Just get away from my door and take her with you.
Tash, calm down.
Or what?
Are you going to let me in?
No.
Look, come on, Tash, let's not fight for hope's sake.
Jamie, just go away and take your slapper girlfriend with you.
Right, I'll get a court order. Tash, I need to see my daughter. Thank you.
You can look after her tonight while I go out.
Fine.
But you're not bringing that Yankee bimbo.
Fine, I'll just take her to the hotel then.
Oh, no, you're not taking my daughter to your sordid love shack.
Tash, you're going to have to get used to the fact that me and Shannon are a couple. We're an item, and she wants to see Hope.
Come round tonight, alone, 7 o'clock. tart with you.
Everyone says that you're really stressed out today.
Yeah, I'm busy.
I've got a cure for tension. I really missed you. Phil's otherwise engaged, so I'm all yours.
Jackie, I've got work to do.
Come on.
I really don't think this is a good idea.
I want you now.
There's nothing I'd like more, but I'm snowed under.
Maybe later then.
Maybe.
Drinks are on you.
Absolutely. I just emptied another cash point machine. We'll have a few, yeah? Mm. A few more drinks, ladies.
I've got to go.
Oh, come on, mate. Don't go. Stay. We'll have a few more drinks.
I've got a hot day.
Oh, don't be a soft touch. We're having a right crack here. A few more drinks won't hurt, will it?
All right, one more, yeah?
Yes!
Come on.
Yes!
Come on, then.
Get in, then! Come on!
Hey. Let me help you with all this. I've got a room in my house that's full of all sorts of United stuff. I was thinking maybe we can shoot there.
Sounds good.
Oh, good night, Patrick. See you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow. Night.
Are you busy?
The Grange at an hour.
Oh, Jackie, are you busy?
Well, yeah.
Because I was thinking, if we're doing a proper day in the life of Phil, then you'll need to be in it, especially if you're doing stuff at home.
Yeah, I was just gonna...
Great idea. I mean, I can't really do it without you, can I? You're not doing anything now, are you?
Well, no. Oh,
come on, then. It'll be fun.
It's me again. My name is Abby Fletcher. I'm your wife, and I'm trying to find you. Phone me. I love you, you pillock.
No sign? Are we going to have that drink, then?
Yeah. He's never done this to me before. I mean, he really hasn't been himself the past couple of days.
Well, it must be worrying for him. The end of the season is not that far away.
Sorry?
He has things to sort out.
What do you mean?
You don't know, do you?
What?
Hasn't been offered a contract and he's not getting offers from other clubs.
Why didn't he tell me?
Snooker challenge, yeah? 50 quid a go. Are you up for it?
I told you, I left my wallet at the club.
Oh, I have this with you. I want it back tomorrow, though, on the rest.
You reckon? Boy, I'll have one game, and that's it.
Oh, get in there, Rob.
Oh, you woman.
One game, I'm telling you.
Right, now you have a good evening, and don't let Daddy boss you around. And don't you tell him any of our secrets, okay? Try and stay awake and make his life as hard as possible. A huge poo would be good, or two. And then sleep for as long as you can when me and Robbie get back. Yeah? Oh, OK, come on in. Wait.
There's a surprise. He's on time. She's not lurking in the bushes, is she?
Give us a break, Tosh. Blimey. You look a bit of all right.
Right, her bottle's ready. It just needs microwaving. Try and keep her awake as long as possible so she sleeps through the night, OK? And I'll be back when I'm back.
All right, then, well, have a good evening. Hello. Hello. Your mummy looks all right, doesn't she? She looks a bit of a yummy mummy. But we have messed things up, haven't we, eh? But don't worry. I'll always make sure you're all right, won't I? Hey?
Hey.
Come on! Get in there! Hang on, them apples! See, this is what it's all about. This is what makes teams click. Being mates, do you know what I mean? Not running around a football pitch for hours on end. All right?
I know.
Me? Oh. Excuse me for a moment, boys. Duty calls.
Go on in.
Good luck.
Oh. That's
That's it. I'm deciding. I'm gonna kill Tara.
What?
Well, she was the one driving. She hit him. I get spotted driving away. So she tells the police I hit.
Lying cow.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, I used to go out every night of the week. Like you girls. You know what I mean, don't you? Hey? But I don't get much chance these days.
You know me and Tash, well, you know.
Yep.
Well, she's blinding. Do you know what I mean? It's like sometimes I have to pinch myself.
Do you want another drink?
Yeah, go on.
Oi, Fletcher, loser, get the beers in.
Can do. But I want those 250s a few later.
Come on, sharpish.
All right.
Chop, chop.
And action.
It's been a 12-hour day already, and there's still so much to do. I'm flagging a bit.
That'll keep you going.
Oh, so sorry. My fault again. I didn't quite get you as he came in, Jackie.
That's the third time, Tara.
I know, I'm so sorry.
Well, it takes as long as it takes, Jackie. We want it to be the best quality, don't we?
Of course we do. The coffee's cold now. I'll get some more.
Is this all right?
Yeah, don't worry.
I will be there as soon as I can. No, don't go anywhere. I will be there.
But he must have known this time would come someday. I mean, you can't stay at the top forever.
That's right. I'm a good few years away, and it's not a happy thought that you'll have to stop doing the job you love.
But Carl doesn't even have to do that yet. You can't play for a Premiership team, a lower league team will take him.
Sure, but you'll have to take less money, of course. Why don't you stay and eat with me? No point sitting at home waiting for him. He can call you whenever he wants.
Okay. Thanks, Marcel.
I'll fix the table.
Robbie, where are you? I'm standing here all on my own. We did say the Grange, didn't we?
It's me again. I need to talk to you. I thought that's what our marriage was about. Talking and looking after each other. Love you.
He's eating her face!
Oh, I shouldn't be doing that. I'm sorry. You're lovely and all that. Whoa, you just witnessed the flinch first. I've just said no to a beautiful woman, and it's because of this little thing on my finger.
Oh, wait. Ryan's gonna kill Tara.
Right, get yourself a lawyer, get him to sort it out, all right? Trust me, I've been there.
You're right, but she is a cow, though. Agreed.
Yeah.
Hey, you having a nice time, or what, eh?
For what?
While a bloke is laying in hospital.
What do you know about it?
Right. You footballers make me sick!
Right,
you
got skin! Hey!
I didn't do nothing!
It wasn't me, all right? Hey!
Right, well, I think that's finally it. I've got the memorabilia. Phil working. How you feel about the lottery win, Phil's plumbing experiences, you two eating supper, and Jackie, how you feel about football?
Yeah, I think you've covered everything in detail, Tara. Don't forget that we need it ready for broadcast tomorrow.
Yes. Looks like an all-nighter for me, then.
Oh, is there any chance I can see it before you transmit?
Yes. I'll have it on your desk in the morning. Right, thank you both for your time.
It's a pleasure.
I'll see myself out.
Talking of all-nighters, how about we go upstairs?
You know, I feel really guilty.
About what?
Putting the pressure on Tara to produce the piece for tomorrow.
So, why not call her and say the next day will do?
No, it has to be ready. We haven't got anything else to screen. I should go and help her.
Why can't we put an old feature on?
Because that's exactly the reason why no one's watching. I'm sorry, darling, but I really want to make HUTV work.
Just keep the sun out, yeah? And we won't press charges against the market, so we're all right. All right?
Yeah.
Look, I'm sorry again, sorry.
Good night, Dave. Good night.
Oh, Rob, what's the time? Mate, how did that happen?
Oh, no. I was supposed to meet Tash.
Yeah, there was someone I was supposed to be, but I can't remember.
Let's just go.
All right.
There's a forest round here.
Boy, let's open this time of night. Think about it, yeah?
Oh, mate. Petrol station to do then. Can you drop me off at the club?
What, is this the grand tour of Archester or something? Eh?
I'm in so much trouble when I get in.
Who cares?
Hi. You look very lovely.
You don't know how much that means to me.
You having a nice time?
And what would that have to do with you?
It's just conversation, Tash, okay? I'm trying to be civil.
Well, I don't want a conversation with you!
Listen, why can't we relate as adults? I know we're sailing the choppy waters of relationship change, but why do we have to communicate with the voice of our inner child?
What Jamie sees in you other than a quick bunk up, love, I'll never know.
Okay, that's enough. Let's get you home. Where's Robbie?
Stood me up.
Him and Fletch have a lot to answer for. Let's get a taxi.
Hey, hurry up, we are!
I need my wallet!
I'm in it deep!
Well, go on, I'll get my own cab.
You're early.
Am I?
Robbie not with you?
Yeah, wearing his invisible coat. How's Hope?
Yeah, fine, great. I couldn't keep her awake, though.
Thanks very much.
So what's up with you?
Nothing. Look, thanks for looking after her. I'll see you soon, yeah?
So have you two had a row or something?
No, why should we have? Robbie got held up.
You want a drink? Gin and tonic, ice and slice?
So she was all right, yeah?
Yeah, fine, great. Sorry your evening didn't work out.
I'm just really surprised by what he did. There's no reason for him to... Wingbacks just simply give you more options. Opportunities, angles, but you've got...
So, aren't you coming to your room, then?
Maybe, in a while. Don't like being kept waiting.
I came as soon as I...
So, as I was saying, angles, you've got to have the right players. Smithy, for example.
Do you want another drink?
No, I should go, really.
Better go and check on Hope, actually. What?
Nothing.
Drink was a nice idea.
Well, I was happy to oblige.
I saw Shannon.
Yeah?
Well, I don't know why I should stop going to the Grange just because she's staying there.
And who said you should?
She was ranting on about some inner child or some sort of rubbish.
And there we were, having a nice drink. And then you go and ruin it all.
You'll wake the baby. Anyway, ruin what? There's nothing to ruin.
Fine. So, when can I see Hope again?
I don't know. I'll think about it.
What about tomorrow?
I said I'll think about it.
So what's the problem with tomorrow?
The problem with tomorrow is that I'm going to have to think about it.
Fine. Well, I can see what Shannon meant when she was talking about the inner child.
Sorry. I've been an idiot. I didn't mean to hurt you. And I love you. Yeah.
Abby, I'm back. Look, I'm sorry, I've been a bit of a... Abby?
Sorry, Tash. I went out drinking with the lads. I lost track of time.
Right.
We went to the dogs, had a few drinks. You know how it is.
Yeah, sure.
I went to the Grange. I said you had gone. You look amazing.
It's a nice dress. Thanks.
Aren't you going to shout at me? Chuck me out?
No. I'm sure it's just one of those things. One drink led to another.
Why aren't you angry with me?
Because I don't feel angry, Robbie. I'm just disappointed. I'm tired. I'm going to bed.
Cheers for that, mate. Sorry if I kept you.
That's all right. You're not the last Tara still working upstairs.
I believe what you say when this is how you behave?
You think I did it?
I think you should plead guilty.
I'm facing a prison sentence because of your lies.
You were driving.
I'm sorry.
Please.
Then I suggest you get to tell the truth. Otherwise, you'll be serving the longest free match ban in history.
True.
Right. We're going to sort this out right now. You're going to call the police and tell them the truth.
Stink of drink.
Call them.
They won't be there now.
Don't make excuses.
I'm not. I'll call them, I promise.
This had better not be one of your lies.
It isn't. I'll call them first thing. I'll speak to Inspector Hughes and I'll tell him that I was driving.
I don't trust you!
Ah, Ryder!
I thought you'd gone.
You're looking at heaven. Carl. Carl. Carl! Those for me?
Well, yeah.
Where have you been? I've been really worried about you.
Oh, to the dogs. And how are the lads?
I've been all around town looking for you.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Been a bit of a jerk.
Just smack you and put you to bed.
Can if you like.
And why didn't you tell me about the contract business?
What? I didn't want to worry her. I'm sorting it.
But if it's worrying you, then we should talk it through. That's the marriage thing. We share our problems, you idiot.
Anyway, how do you know?
About the contract. Marcel told me.
What's it got to do with him?
He was worried for you. He bought me dinner at the Grange.
Well, my life's my business. No one else's. What contracts I sign, whatever I do, it's my business.
Carl, I was only trying to help.
Yeah, I'm going to bed.
What are you doing?
You won't phone tomorrow. You're too devious. So how about you confess to the camera? Just do as I say. Tell the camera exactly what happened.
No.
Do it!
I was the one driving the car that hit the man. We stopped and Ryan drove away. We were spotted driving away. I hit the man.
Tash, what was in breakfast? I'll leave it on the side, yeah? I've got to go training.
You didn't come a bit.
Nah, I sat up thinking. I didn't get much sleep.
You look awful.
I feel all right. Well, not about what I've done to you, though.
I was looking forward to it so much.
I know. I'm an idiot.
Planned it all out. Been thinking about that meal all day. It's always the way, isn't it, when you plan something, rehearse it in your head. It's always disappointing.
Well, let's go out tonight, then.
I spent most of yesterday trying to find a babysitter for Hope. I think I'll just stay in.
Can I stay in with you?
Do you wanna?
Yeah.
Abs? Abby?
Look, I'll cook for you tonight. Whatever you want. So long as it's pasta and sauce in a jar.
Sounds good to me.
What was that meal like in your head?
Sorry?
Last night, you said you were thinking about a meal, rehearsing it.
It's nothing.
Now, go on.
OK. It was great. We both looked lovely, and we drank champagne.
What did we eat?
You had steak, and I had fish. We smiled and talked lots. I held your hand, and people looked at us and said, look at that couple, don't they look right for each other? And then I told you I loved you.
I love you too.
And then I asked you to move in with me.
Right. And what did I say?
But it doesn't matter, I've asked you now.
Even after last night?
What do you think, Robbie?
Yeah, well, it's a big one. It sounds great.
But you want to think about it?
I do love you. I'll be around for lunch, yeah?
Great.
I've got to go. I'm in so much trouble with the gaffer. See you later.
Bye.
Didn't hear you come in.
Well, I did.
Did you get my messages?
But they weren't about football, so I deleted them.
Gaffer hit the roof, understandably. You'll get it in the neck today.
I know.
Where did you go?
Out.
Don't forget, you're going to sign in with the police today.
Well, I hadn't forgotten, but I won't have to.
What are you talking about?
Well, there's not going to be a court case. Not against me, anyway.
What do you mean?
What I said.
I gotta go.
You look as tired as I feel. What are you doing?
You've got to cover for me. Tell Phil that I was working here with you last night.
As opposed to his manager?
Please, Tara, I'm begging you.
Where should I lie for you?
I hope you're going to apologize to Abby for the way you treated her.
I'm sorry? What business is it of yours?
She's worried for you. All right. Fletch.
Oh, are you talking to me or to Clyde?
Can we talk?
We are, Carl.
I mean privately.
Well, no, I'm working. Later, maybe, if you're going to be reasonable.
Yeah, fine. Okay, I'll speak to you later.
You know, if you and Fletch have a split up, can I give you my phone number?
Oi, Robbie! You joining us today?
Yeah, good one.
Man, you are in it so deep.
Cheers.
There you go. Thanks for the loan, mate.
Lovely. What are you so chirpy about?
Nothing, mate.
Oh, look, Three Musketeers. Hope it was worth it, lads, because I've just seen the expression on the gaffer's face.
Wouldn't want to be in your shoes.
This is fantastic.
No, really good. You've done so well.
Thanks.
Hey, stranger. God, you look shattered. Both of you. Been on the job all night.
Yeah.
What, no Kip?
I'll never forget the first time we were tied up some road.
If we wanted it ready, we had to keep working.
Well, you both deserve a medal. This is really good work.
Good. I'm glad that you like it.
Yeah, well, I couldn't have done it without Jackie. Could have, Jax? Coming up the steps at the back there.
Ah. I remember the faces. I was wondering how to do this. I thought, call you into my office one by one. And then I thought, why should I show you that respect? You show me no respect. So I'm going to tell you here, in front of everybody. For missing training, obviously I'm going to fine you the maximum. 2 weeks' wages. You are an utter nightmare, and you have been ever since you joined. I'm offloading you as soon as I can find a club stupid enough to take you on. You're training in the reserves. You know that I have been pulling my hair out over your inconsistency. You know that because I've told you. And how do you repay me? Insolence. Rebellion.
Look, Gaffer, I'm sorry I was...
Shut up. You know I don't need you. But I hear you're having trouble trying to find a club that's prepared to pay for your ageing talents. Playing in the reserves isn't going to aid your cause. Walsall, Tuesday.
Gaffer, phone.
And finally, for bringing this club into disrepute, brawling in a bar. Don't tell me you haven't read the papers. I'm again going to find you the maximum. 2 weeks' wages. You three are an utter disgrace to your profession.
I paid the bouncers to keep this quiet.
Fletch! Carl!
Have you done it yet?
No, I haven't.
Because I'm now being thrown out of the club, mainly because of this. So, do you want to do it now?
Okay. It's just, it's very difficult.
No, it's very easy. You just pick up the phone and you tell the truth.
Okay. I'll tell the truth. That Ryan Naismith attacked me last night, was violent with me, forced me to say something that was untrue. And if they want proof, well, hey, there's a tape. I was clearly being held there against my wishes. It must be a very serious offence.
Ryan, shouldn't you be in training?
So, you find a month's wages, get dropped to the reserves, get involved in a bar brawl, and are unspeakably rude to your long-suffering wife. Not bad for a day off. And the club has offered you a reduced contract for the next 3 years.
8 poxy grand a week. They're having a laugh.
So fight for your contract, or move to another team.
Yeah, all right. I will.
I'm on your side, Carl. You don't get it, do you? I'm here for you, and you're supposed to be here for me.
I'm sorry.
Good. An epoxy, 8 grand a week? There's plenty of people that have to get by on that for a year. And I don't love your money. I love you, Carl Fletcher. Even if you never earned another penny, we'd have enough to live on for the rest of our lives.
Yeah, well, you're wrong there, aren't you? I need another contract.
Why?
Because I've got no money.
What do you mean?
I haven't saved a bean. No pensions, nothing. And I got this yesterday. Tax bill. I'm skint abs. It's gonna clean me out.
Anything else you haven't told me? Good. Because I'm not sure I could take it right now.
You said you never married me for my money.
I didn't. I didn't marry you for your lies either.
How could you be so stupid?
How did you?
He's slinging you out! And you'll never get a sniff of the first team here again. You might as well wear a sign round your neck saying my career is over.
Oh, come on!
No, you come on! I took you in. I put my job on the line to get you into this club, and I've done everything I can to support you. And what do I get in return? You're a liar and a waste of space, Ryan. You're no son of mine.
Oh, come on, Dad!
Not too bad,
mate. Cash, it's me.
Hi, babe, you all right?
For someone who's been ripped apart in front of his teammates.
Find 4 weeks' wages, I feel on top of the world.
Why is that?
Because I've decided I want to live with the woman I love. If she still wants me.
She does. But only if you're really, really sure, Robbie.
Hand on heart, I've never felt surer of anything.
I love you, Robbie.
Gaffer's coming. I'll speak to you later. Love you.
You're not training with us today.
No, I am, Gaffer. It was an important call. I'm ready now.
No, you don't understand. You're not training with us today because I've had an important call from Stevie Coppell. Go home and pack your bags. I'm loaning you to Brighton and Hove Albion.
Coming soon on Dream Team.
Stuart Naismith hits the all-important goal!
How is Ryan? Hope he bucked up his ideas.
Yeah, it's about Ryan, mate.
What is it?
There's been a bit of an accident. After all these years, this is Lottie's reward.
You were never exactly a model citizen, were you, Fletch?
Catch your guy.
Tonight at 9, Ed Saunders introduces a new crop of contestants to a slugfest in Fear Factor.